Diana Ross, superstar, appearing here right now, and a fight fan. Been all over the world with that lady, her opening in London, her opening in Paris. Always she goes, and there he is, the Yankee Clipper, the man who looks better with every passing year. He's here with another guy. They have the best-looking white hair in the world, the two of them. They've grown gray beautifully. And the man I'm talking about, you are about to see. There he is, Cary Grant. Once he was Archie Leach, a stilt walker at Coney Island. He became one of the greatest stars in the history of motion pictures. We're back to Earnie Shavers. I tell you, it's worth it to get old if you can look like DiMaggio and Grant, Chris.
Why, don't you? Tell you one thing. Davy Pearl is the referee of the scheduled 15-round championship bout, and I would think that he'd rub off some of the grease on the body and face of Larry Holmes. We'll see if he does.
What was your honest opinion of Holmes' tactic?
I thought it was Bush. You know, you don't, you're the champion, and I don't think you keep a man like this waiting. But they did. And you said, talked about a set of pipes. Marvin Gaye is in the ring, Howard, to sing our national anthem. Tremendous talent.
And a very sad man because he owns Andy Price, whom Leonard destroyed. Here is Marvin Gaye with the anthem. Seconds to allow our local stations to identify themselves. That's Earnie Shavers, and in this jam-packed house, many of the fans were just on their feet chanting, Earnie, 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 Earnie. You have to like him, you have to respect him. A great deal of hardship in his life. But now, this one last chance that we talked about before and kept waiting in the ring. And I respect your candor, Chris. I respect it a very great deal when you said you thought Larry's behavior, there is Holmes right there, was Bush.
Well, it's unlike a young man that I really care a great deal about. We've known him a long time, Howard, and I just think he was ill-advised.
All right, let's go to Chuck Hull, the ring announcer, for the introduction of the fighters.
Ladies and gentlemen, the judges assigned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission for the next bout are Harold Buck, Lou Tabbitt, and Hal Miller. The referee is Dave Pearl. This is the main event of the evening. 15 rounds of boxing for the World Boxing Council Heavyweight Championship. Introducing, in the blue corner, fighting out of Warren, Ohio, weighing 213 pounds, the challenger, Earnie Shaver. And in the red corner, fighting out of Easton, Pennsylvania, weighing 210 pounds, he is undefeated in his professional career, the champion, the Eastern Assassin, Larry Holmes. 50 rounds of boxing.
All right, there were the introductions by Chuck Hull. Quickly, 10-point must system, mandatory 8-count, no standing 8-count, no knockdown limit. 3 knockdowns in a round does not automatically terminate the fight. Fighter cannot be saved by the bell except in the final round. The three judges, Harold Buck, Lou Talbot, and Hal Miller, scoring the fight. The referee is Dave Pearl. And, of course, in Holmes' corner, where there has been some friction and some unsettlement, Rich Giacchetti, the manager trainer, the cut man, Freddie Brown, and in the corner, there's Giacchetti, who just saw him, the bell for round one. Keith Clever is also in Holmes' corner. The doctor who made his arm well again and apparently made pitcher Frank Tanana's arm well again. First round action. Let's watch and see how much Larry Holmes moves. Shaver's wanting to cut off the ring. Nail Holmes quickly, the way he did Kenny Norton. But Kenny's battle plan played right into Norton's hands, into Shaver's hands. This is first round action. Rapier left. A critical weapon for Holmes. Holmes now delivers the right with much more authority than he used to. The body following through better, with getting the power of the body into the arm. It used to be just a swish. First round. They're in ring center. So far, Larry has not been moving the way he did in the first fight. When quickly, there you saw a touch of it, now back. Lateral movement was his weapon as much as anything in the first fight, March 25th, a year ago. 3 quick lifts by Larry Holmes. Holmes, tall, big man, great reach. But Earnie's reach almost as long. Not that much by way of reach advantage. Now, if there's improvement in Earnie, who tried to go to the belly there with the right, it would have to be in the delivery of the left jab. It used to be nothing. Now it appears he's been improved. In his corner, of course, Frank Luca, Audie Dorr, Ed Hayes. Now you've got the nuts and bolts of it. We're into the final minute of round one. We saw Holmes dance out of trouble. He had thrown a right, and he didn't want to leave himself open to Shavers. So he quickly moved out of trouble, which you must do when you're fighting Earnie Shaver. Oh, Holmes, very clever. Very clever there. Had Shaver's off balance when he hit him with the right. Holmes wanting to reestablish himself in the minds of so many after the relatively lackluster showing against Mike Weaver. And Holmes boxing well in this first round as we approach the end of it.
action. Photography is easy with the Minolta XG1 35mm reflex.
Hi, I'm Christy Jenner. I just focus and touch this electronic button to give me great pictures automatically.
The XG loads easily, too. This signal shows me that the film is loaded properly, and the electronic self-timer lets us get into our own pictures.
Minolta XG1,
the automatic choice for action photography.
Natural light beer, please. XG, I guess you're supposed to say, give me a natural or make it a natural. Okay, so I'm a maverick. But, you know, I just walked out of a bar because they didn't have natural light beer.
You must have been humidified.
So was I.
I empathize with you. You know, a cabin without the smooth, clean taste of this light beer is downright unnatural.
You know, that's so true. That's why I came in here for a natural. There you go. I just said natural. It goes to show you. I guess you hear something so often, you naturally just follow along like a flock of sheep. Monkey see, monkey do.
Round two. We are coming to you live from ringside in Las Vegas, Nevada. Second round, Holmes against Shavers. Holmes is back to you. Shavers is such a strong man, but Holmes quickly with that left jab wants to make it a repeat of the first fight when he was an easy winner by decision. Shavers winds up for his punches. Well, Frank Luca claims, oh, not the way he used to. There was that left jab. And this man is so strong that when he touches you, you wake all over. One thing is clear, this was no Kenny Norton fight plan against Shavers. Holmes knows what he's about. He's got great hand speed for a heavyweight and excellent foot speed. See that left jab? So far, it's the dominant blow in the fight. On Ascot Guard, Holmes won the first round without too much trouble. Jabbing away with that left. A couple of them getting through Ernie's gloves. Earnie, as of old, looking for the opening to destroy the opponent with a one punch. This is a one punch knockout fighter, Chris.
Yes, and Holmes with a crack classic strategy of jab and move, jab and move. That's an impressive, menacing left jab.
Well, his movement off those ropes and away from Shavers in the first round was an evidence that he's got his battle plan. Look at that left again and again and again. Doubling, tripling on it. And then back with another. And then moving quickly out of danger. That's the second time he's done that beautifully tonight. Holmes is fighting at this point beautifully. At this point. See the countdown for round two. Lower right-hand corner of your screen. Holmes winning the second round with relative ease. Oh, that was the right. That hurt Holmes. It got in right under the chin.
What is American Motors doing for 1980 that no other car maker has ever done?
Building the only family compact automobile with automatic four-wheel drive, the American Eagle. Building a luxury compact that goes 484 miles on one tank of gas. AMC Concorde. Building every Concorde, Spirit, Pacer, and American Eagle automobile to last.
With Zevart factory rust protection as the cars are being built at no extra cost. And guaranteeing them with the only 5-year no-rust-through warranty at no extra cost. And AMC's buyer protection plan with the only full 12-month, 12,000-mile warranty in the industry that covers every part, even if it just plain wears out. Also at no extra cost. Look at American Motors in 1980. You'll see things you just won't see anywhere else.
American Motors, built for today, built to last for tomorrow.
We're back live, Las Vegas, round three just underway. Round two, a replica of their first fight. Chavis landed a right that hurt Holmes in the first fight. Earnie jabbed and danced out of trouble. Here, just before the second round ended, Chavis reached Holmes with a right, hurt him. Chavis getting instructions from Frank Luca between the rounds, telling Earnie he must throw that right more and must get more into it. Said you're not bringing your body through behind that right. 45 seconds into round three. That left constantly troubling Chavis. No matter how he keeps those gloves up there, to look at that. Measuring Chavis with his left. Point. Remember when Ali did that to Sonny Liston? Larry Holmes. Minute 15 into round three. Earnie bobbing and weaving, looking for the opening. Coming close once or twice, but not yet finding it. Holmes 30. Chavis a listed 35. The man who would, one would think would have to win early would be Chavis. The stamina would seem to belong to the younger man, and he has proved that stamina, especially in his classic war against Kenny Norton. We have a minute left in the third round. The pattern of the fight, the same. Larry Holmes left, working over Earnie Chavis. Holmes not moving as much, though you see the movement there, as he did in the first fight. Chavis trying to get that right into the belly. Believe me, he has simply stunning power. Remember in the interview, Chavis said he would go to the belly. There's a left that got to Holmes' chin. The right missed.
Oh,
right there.
Lovely.
I'll tell you. Chavis hits, and immediately the opponent is hurt. And you can see it happen to Holmes.
This bud's for everyone who's into hot tracks and red-hot cars.
This bud's for you, for all you do. The king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. The Budweiser Spider and the clean, crisp taste of the king of beers. This Bud's for you.
When you need your car now, but you're number 10 in line for service, you're number 1 at Budget Rent-A-Car. When your number 3 son leaves you with no car, you're number 1 at Budget. Whenever you've got any number of places to go, but no car to get there, get a great rate on a great car, plus the great feeling your business really counts.
At Budget, you're number 1.
For reservations, call toll-free or see the Yellow Pages.
Round 4, live from Las Vegas, Nevada. Holmes against Chavis. And if there's a difference from the first fight thus far, it would be that Holmes is not moving nearly as much. He may pay for that because he was stunned in that third round by Chavis. There is that good Holmes left, though, and there you saw him double up on that rapier-like jab. That's some fast jab for a heavyweight to have, especially one as big as Larry. You just saw him throw it 3 times in a row, 2 connected. Moving to the left, back to the right, back and forth, not providing a target, which is the way to fight Earnie Chavis. Make one mistake and you can go in a hurry. Earnie wild and missing with a right. Don't forget, we're in the fourth round. Each fighter predicted the fifth round in that interview you saw earlier. Staying away from Shavers after scoring with the left jab. The pattern seemingly redundant now. And very much in the manner of the first fight. But you never know. See, Earnie keeps the gloves up, but Holmes' left gets good. A good combination. And Earnie laughing about it. But he felt it. And yet Holmes staying out of danger. That's the movement. Now tying up Shavers. David Pearl trying to break them apart. Larry Holmes fighting his fight. Holmes again with a good left. Shavers desperately wanting to tag. Holmes suddenly with a right lead that got in there. And you saw the measure, and you saw a good right uppercut by Larry. It was the right uppercut that floored Weaver in the 11th round of Holmes' last fight in New York in June. There's the right lead again, another right. And suddenly, Holmes is adopting a new weapon, the right lead. And Holmes is making this fight his way thus far.
When I looked at Datsun 280ZX and Porsche 924, I also looked at this new Mazda RX-7, and that's all it took.
Just one look, that's all it took, yeah, just one look, that's all it took.
You get a lot of refined sports car with the Mazda RX-7, you also get great mileage, and you get it all at a price that'll really make you look twice.
Yeah, the more you look, the more you like.
There is a company that gives you automatic one-button microwave cooking. This company gives you AM/FM weather band plus a clock radio and television all in one set. This company gives you an incredibly dramatic 5-foot diagonal TV picture. This company gives you portable videotape to go. Who do you think this company is? It's we're building our reputation on one great idea after another, after another.
Back live round five. Earnie Shavers suffered a cut in the corner of the left eye that was repaired between rounds. And Frank Lucas said to him, you've got to jab more and you've got to throw the right more. But so far, Holmes has made the fight. Set the pace, fighting his kind of fight, using the left and then unveiling in the latter part of the fourth round. A tremendous series of rights, three of them right leads. Fifth round action, a round when Earnie said he would knock out Larry Holmes. And Larry Holmes said he would knock out Earnie Shavers. Now Shavers trying to get down to the belly to reach Holmes and weaken him. But you see Holmes with that movement staying away. He'll go back to that left jab now to reset the pace. See, there he goes. Use the left, set up the right. Earnie not yet able to get to Larry Holmes. Right there, Shavers landed a right. And Larry Holmes still, and the left got to Holmes. I tell you, you can't measure the power of Earnie Shavers. It is devastating. Unquestionably the best puncher alive. So you must always be careful. Shavers getting the right into the belly. So, not looping, swinging wildly, looking for the head of the knockout. There. Holmes came back with a sir. There's the right lead again. Another right lead. Then the left again. Scoring still with many more punches than Earnie. Right there. What Holmes must remember is to be careful. If he does that and fights this kind of fight, should be no problem. His skills are great, and he is young. Counting down to the end of round five. This was the round when Earnie landed a couple of good ones. I thought that would bring a warning from referee Pearl. The end of the round at hand.
This bud's for all the people who make the sidelines a part of the show.
This bud's for you. For all you do, the king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you, that distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do,
this Bud's for you.
Sorry, no experience, no job.
But where do I get the experience?
Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines.
We don't ask for experience.
We give it.
You won't read it in a book.
You live it.
Pick a service. Pick a challenge. Set yourself apart.
Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines. What a great place. It's a great place to start.
Back live start of the sixth round. Earnie Shaver's left eye, very red. Appears to be in bad shape. Frank Lucas said to referee Dave Pearl, he thumbed him in the eye, and what did you do about it? Dave Pearl said, knock it off. He never thumbed him, he hit him. Just a little bit of the byplay as with the sixth round gets underway. No question that so far Holmes is fighting his kind of fight. Right there, a strong Shaver's punch against the right side of Holmes, and Holmes moving away as you saw. Believe me, that punch hurt him. Sixth round action. Holmes back to the left, on his toes. Enough movement to stay out of range, and with his reach, make that left jab work as he just did twice. And the right. That right goes into that left eye, and that left went to that eye. And Earnie doesn't seem to know what to do about Holmes, about the left, about the right lead, about the steady movement. The left. Same story. Shaver's getting into the midriff there. Once, twice. Larry tying him up. Oh. A minute left in this, the sixth round. Wild right that missed. Another wild right that missed. Throwing and missing that way takes something out of him. Now the other eye appears cut. The other eye of Shaver's. He's in deep trouble. And Shaver's was stunned by that Holmes right. Shaver's was hurt. Look at the right eye now. Blood streaming down over him. Shaver's in deep trouble now in the sixth round as Larry Holmes comes back to the kind of form he had prior to the Mike Weaver bout. 15 seconds, counting down, round six. Big round for Larry Holmes. Holmes totally dominating the fight. We will go to Ernie's corner as this round ends. and you better know he knows.
Huh? Yeah, you're shoving the thing in too far. That one, Eddie, that one.
Try to pick up some of that natural sound.
You gotta keep your hands out. You're getting through with the cuffs. Gotta keep your hands out, you hear? Deep breath. Hands up, Ernie. Cut him off in the corners. In the corners.
That's Frank. Frank Luca talking to him. You heard him say, keep the hands up. He's getting to you with the cuts. Keep the hands up, Earnie. Now, by way of contrast, Larry Holmes.
That's
right.
Holmes looking so fresh by contrast. You heard Cicchetti and Freddie Brown. Keep that jab going. He can't hit you. A lot of blood on Holmes's trousers. Trunks, not trousers. But the blood is the blood of Earnie Shavers. As Larry goes right to work and reopens the cut over the right arm instantly. Pecking away with that jab. This is the seventh round. We are live from Las Vegas, Nevada. Out of the right eye of Earnie Shavers. A terrible thing to see. As Holmes is relentless in the use of that jab, and occasionally the right, as you saw that. Shavers fighting half blindly now, trying to get in. Holmes dancing out of trouble. The right was one of those long Shavers powerhouse fights. And Shavers has been following Holmes ever since. Holmes moving. This is why you can't ever count Earnie Shavers out. Holmes, the leg's a little bit wobbly. Now Holmes isn't able to move off of those ropes, which is where Shavers wants it. We have a minute left or thereabouts in this, the seventh round. And Holmes was really hurt by that Shavers right. Shavers put the right into the midsection. Holmes seems to be coming to himself now. But he... He is holding on. He got caught with that Earnie Shavers right. Earnie wild, trying to get at Holmes. Earnie swinging wildly. Holmes trying to hold together. Earnie Shavers at age 35 or whatever, with 10 seconds left now in the round. Holmes defenseless, taking it from Shavers. Holmes, the end of the round here.
She was the most beautiful girl I had ever seen.
Even though he doesn't know who she is.
Sir.
This man will cross the hottest sands, climb the highest mountains, and sail the deepest seas to make his dream come true. Because on a scale from 1 to 10, he's about to meet a 10. 10 rated R. See your fantasy come true at a theater near you. Check local listings.
The world won't stop when you want to photograph it, but the Olympus OM-10 can stop the world. The OM-10 is fully automatic. This Olympus tells you when you can shoot and when you can't. You change lenses in seconds with the OM-10. Or put on a winder and lock in the action at 3 frames per second. The Olympus OM-10 even has a self-timer, so you can get in the action instead of just watching it. With Olympus OM-10, great shots automatically.
What noise! What a turn of events! Round 8, Las Vegas, Earnie Shavis with the first knockdown of the fight. Holmes had dropped his left. Shavis came over it with the long right, and Holmes was ready to go. But he somehow lasted the round. Let's see how he will hold together now. A half-fine Shavis was being boxed apart by Larry Holmes, who had things all his own way the first six rounds and was having them his own way in the seventh. Both of Shavis' eyes cut. And then suddenly, the one mistake. And a puncher like Shavis can kill you with that one mistake. So we are in the eighth round. And Holmes is back to his pattern. He's moving. He seems well enough. The blood again pouring down from Holmes's right eye. From Shavis' right eye, correction. And the Holmes left getting in there again and again. But now all eyes are focused on that Shavis' right as Holmes runs. And do you blame him after what he got in the last round? We'll have a station break at the end of this round so the two stations can be alerted for it down the line. This is the eighth round, and this fight has become something. Earnie wanting to get that right in there one more time. Holmes fell with a clump to the canvas. Last round. Mistake. Once they said Larry Holmes didn't have courage. They said it about him in the Olympic trials against Wayne Bobbitt. He has shown his courage. He showed it five times over. A good right by Holmes in the fight against Kenny Norton that went the distance. Each fighter said the other has dog in it. I can't believe they meant it. I don't see any dog in either man. Holmes knowing he must keep moving. He must keep moving from Holmes' point of view. Earnie now in trouble himself again. It's gone back the other way. But the wild right. Holmes failing to take advantage of Shavis when he was off balance. Holmes tired. But Holmes. Holmes having himself a big round after the knockdown. We'll return with more boxing action after this from our local station.
Dead tired and losing his cool.
Holmes. That's the way Earnie Shavis' left eye looks. It's all but shut. He is fighting half blind, as I said. Holmes appeared dead tired at the end of round eight, but he came back big from the sudden knockdown in round seven. Holmes showing his gameless Shavis. Nobody could fight a gamer fight than he is fighting. Right, the right hurt him. Shavis is hurt. He's against the ropes. He's defenseless now. Or half so. Or so it seems. A wild swing by Shavis. Hard for him to see the opponent. This has turned into a brawl. The six rounds of boxing lesson delivered by Holmes. The seventh. The Holmes left drop. The Shavis right. Nailed him. Down went Holmes. The only knockdown in the fight. But look at Holmes. There's the right. Again, doesn't Holmes look tired to you? A little bit wavering, a little bit wobbly. It seemed to me that at the very end of the last round, though, Holmes had a big comeback round. He was about to lose his cool. Right there, he showed his cool. Scoring with a combination. There. These two fighters are exhausted now. And Earnie Shaver is talking to Holmes, trying to taunt him. But Earnie Shaver, with the left eye virtually closed, the right eye, not bleeding at the moment, but bleeding throughout the fight. Earnie just keeping the hands up there, hoping that somehow he will get the right in. For a minute 45 into the ninth round. Just hoping, that's what Shaver is doing, that the right will connect. He was this way, appeared this done in his fight against Roy Williams, Shaver's was. But then, suddenly, at the very end, he bailed it out. Holmes, scoring with the blow. Low, good uppercut. Shaver's hurt again against the ropes. Earnie trying to fight back, but Earnie now himself ready to go down. How much more? There's a wild ride. Left himself wide open. He is just blinded. He's now taking. Look at that right and that right and that right and the uppercut, the right, the left uppercut. And Holmes is mercilessly laying the blows upon him. But Earnie, as he staggers there, half going down. No movement by referee. He's coming back there, right there. Shaver's incredibly scored with the right, and it was Holmes who went down. He got careless.
He ruled it.
And so, Shaver, this is just incredible.
He ruled that no knockdown.
Lovely, lovely. And now a word from our beauty contest winner.
I'm fed up, and I'm not going to waste my money anymore.
It's Toyota time.
Don't waste, but don't do without. Toyota time is the best time to get the best selection and best deal on Toyota's sporty Celica. Get European style and handling with Toyota's total economy and a car that's fun to drive year after year.
It's Toyota time!
When you've got it, you've got it.
Toyota!
Hey, don't worry. They just got lucky.
I'm sorry. I let us down.
Forget it. We'll beat them next week.
No, I really let us down.
Come on. How about a Michelob Light, huh?
Michelob makes a light beer?
Sure.
The good taste of Michelob Light. Don't just compare it to other light beers. Compare it to your regular beer. It's that good.
And this Michelob Light is great. Hey, you know what our real problem was today?
Yeah, you were terrible.
Good taste runs in the family.
Round 10, and I have just talked with referee Dave Pearl, who said because there was no mandatory eight count, we had to ask him. He said, I ruled out a slip. The blow was on the shoulder. I ruled it a slip, not a knockdown for Earnie Shaver. Well, he's got a right to rule it. He's in there.
But Howard, there is a mandatory eight count on all knockdowns.
I understand that. He called that knockdown a slip. That's what I'm saying. We're in the 10th round. This crowd responding to the courage of Earnie Shaver. Did you see him in the 9th round? And now he's taking it again. His body was bent over in two, and yet he did not go to the canvas. Look at that uppercut. Holmes continues to win the fight up to this point. But always there is the danger of what happened in the 7th round, where there was, by the referee's precepts, a clean knockdown. Earnie got in a left. You have to keep watching for every blow Earnie throws. They are few and far between now. But if they can connect, Ernie's doing the talking, as you saw. Both fighters exhausted. Both of them. Look at that. That's not professional fighting, but there is nothing left but the heart. And Holmes half falling over himself from fatigue. This is the way it was with Norton and Holmes when they were both exhausted at the end. There is Earnie, just trying to land that right. He landed one. They are both so tired. Holmes just looked down at his corner for an instruction. Holmes back with a flurry. How he does it, I don't know. We're almost at the end of round two. Now, what is he doing here? I don't understand what referee Dave Pearl is doing. It looked like he was going to stop the fight. Back comes Shaver, but he didn't. I will talk to him between rounds again.
Block of ice, but when we chopped through the ice, the car started on the first try using Shell fire and ice motor oil. The same car tows a 30-ton crane through desert heat, but the engine is still protected by Shell fire and ice motor oil. Give your car's engine this year-round protection. Ask your Shell dealer for Shell fire and ice 10W40 motor oil. Shell fire and ice.
Fred, this cold is killing me.
Are you in luck? Here are those new all-purpose cold medicines.
I'd feel better about Contact.
Look, helps sneezing, dripping.
Contact does that and longer.
Postnasal drip, congestion.
Contact does that and longer. Even flu's congestion.
Plus certain things for aches and cough.
I don't care to take, and Contact chose not to use.
I'll level with you. I take Contact myself.
Now you tell me.
Contact helps for all your congestive symptoms and helps them longer.
We're back live. Referee Dave Pearl, apparently totally confused, halted the action in the waning seconds of round 10 because he said he thought the bell had rung. There was still about 18 seconds to go. There's Holmes with the right off Shavers. 11th round action coming to you live from Las Vegas, Nevada. And both fighters exhausted. We have had one official knockdown. It occurred in the 7th round. It came from nowhere. Shavers executed it against Holmes. A long, hard right over Holmes' left, which had dropped. Seemed to have repaired the cut over Ernie's right eye, or over the corner of it. But the left eye remains virtually shut. Davis Corner said, stay with him, stay with him. If you land one, he's gone. Look at that, though. Earnie bent over almost in two. Defenseless, his hands at his side. Tremendous fight. In terms of a brawl, not in terms of skills anymore. Excitement engendered by the courage of Earnie. Look at him smiling as he takes blow upon blow. We're a minute 45 into the 11th round.
Howard, it's like Ollie said, he's a tough acorn to crack.
He really is. Look at that right against the left side of his face. Dave Pearl, the referee, checking with Earnie, trying to find out if he knows where he's at. That's it. It's stopped by Dave Pearl. It's an 11th round technical knockout. Larry Holmes, the winner, and still the champion. But he almost lost it. He almost lost it to the courage and right hand of a man who's listed as 35. There'll be no more times around for Earnie Shavers. Oh, maybe he'll fight again, but there'll be no more championship chances. So it ends for him. But it ends for him in a very gallant way. And it ends for him with, as you look at Holmes, his arms upraised. It ends for Earnie Shavers with the crowd standing and cheering his courage. And so, it has been done again, and Holmes is the winner. We'll be back at ringside in a moment. So we are back live at Caesar's Palace in the Sports Pavilion. The crowd is still here. No one has left. They realize that a boxing lesson turned suddenly into a brawl, that it happened in the seventh round. They realized that Earnie Shavers doesn't have the greatest of skills. Clearly, Holmes has the better skills. He's a boxer. He can move. Earnie can't. But they loved the man's courage, and they loved the power of his punch, and the excitement he brought to this arena when it happened in the seventh round. In the meantime, in the ninth round, there was that mix-up where the referee called it a slip. There is Earnie, depressed, understandably so. The great dream now over. And here comes Larry Holmes down now to talk with us. A tired Larry Holmes.
2 minutes. Amy Pearl, the referee, stops the bout. The winner, and still, heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Holmes.
The official announcement. As you continue to look at Earnie Shavers. And what a disappointment for that man. But what a triumph for Larry Holmes. And here is Larry Holmes with me now. The camera to turn upon us. I want to tell you one thing, my friend. We're still waiting for the camera to come down on us. We've also been joined by Rich Giacchetti. And it was, well, it was, as I said, in the end of brawl. There we are on that camera, Larry.
Listen, Lisa, I love you. I'm all right. I'm a bad champion.
I'll tell you one thing that you men both prove. There's not a bit of dog in either one of you.
Yes, it is, Howard. Doberman. Remember I told you that? All Doberman. Knock me down, I come back.
Give Shavers credit. He did catch in that seventh round. You know that.
Howard, I talk a lot. I try to sell myself as a champion. I feel that I have proved myself over 32 fights. Earnie Shavers would knock all of them out. The hard puncher, Earnie Shavers. The only thing about it, I can absorb the punishment. And I feel that I'll be champion for a long time. I'm still going to give all the heavyweights a chance to get something that I didn't get. That was the shot at the heavyweight champion. I proved myself out. I'm tired of proving it.
Okay. What I wondered about, Larry, was you talked about Shavers as a hard puncher. His punches next to yours in number were few and far between. But did he hurt you earlier, before the seventh round? I saw a blow in the second. I saw another in the fourth. I felt he might have been stunned.
He hit me hard enough to make me realize that he can punch. And I feel sorry for all the heavyweights that Earnie Shavers fight because he's galloped and he proved himself as a boxer, a puncher, and he can go the distance. It's just that I was hitting so far, so much, it took a lot out of him. I cannot discredit Earnie Shavers or any boxer who gets in the ring with me. As you know, I worked very hard for Earnie, and if I didn't work as hard as I did, Earnie Shavers would be the heavyweight champion of the world.
Right. All right, I want to show the viewers once again round seven, I'd like you to talk over at the time when he floored you out of nowhere because you had given him a boxing lesson in the early rounds.
Oh,
Let's take a look at it now. Go ahead, Larry.
See, I was so confident. And that's just to show you can't keep building up confidence with a puncher like that. But I'm a boxer, and this man is slick. I watch the films, and he just waited, and I'm waiting for him to throw that overhand right over my left, which he does. That's why I try to lean to my left quite as much as I can, lean to my right. Because he's strong, and I don't care what John Tate and all them other fighters do. Earnie Shavers will take them all. I don't care what they say. And I just proved to you again, Howard, I'm the baddest heavyweight in the world. Got up from a puncher and whoop him.
Right there, he got that right over your left. And you were getting careless with your left, as you said, beginning to drop it.
Confidence, Howard. And that just to show you. You got to go in there. We're all fighting.
Hold on 1 second, Larry. Earnie! Yes. We're going to be talking to Earnie right after we finish this. Earnie's coming right over. But you pick up, Larry.
Earnie's a strong fighter, and I don't care what he says. He wear a man down. He take him out. He hit him. I just blessed by God that I am chosen to represent all people throughout the world as a heavyweight champion. I was able to absolve this man's punishment. Because he's one hell of a puncher, and I feel that everybody watching this on ABC knows it. Earnie Shavers will always fight and represent any network in the world as a worthy contender, because he is a champion in his own right. And I don't care what nobody says, he's the number one contender in the world.
All right, we're looking at thoughts of action.
Right hand, hit me with fear.
Yep.
But I proved again that I can take it.
This was round seven.
Bam. Nope, that wasn't it, huh? Hit me with an overhand right.
You'll say it. I hope.
Well, ABC don't miss nothing.
That's very kind.
I'm just proud that ABC has represented me.
There it was.
Right here.
You see that, Richie? Right over the left. A perfectly thrown right.
Because he didn't double jab. When he didn't double jab that time, Earnie countered him with an overhand right. He had a double jab and pushed him back, and he never got hit with the punch.
That, of course, the voice of manager Rich Giacchetti of the still WBC heavyweight champion Larry Holmes. Larry, you were in deep trouble here.
I'm telling you the truth. I'm telling you how, but I know that I was fighting for the world, for the people, to prove myself as a champion, a people's champion. And I want to say, Howard, I want to thank you for giving me the opportunity to say nice things about me. Also, I want to thank Jim Spence for being a hell of a director. He's one hell of a guy, and all the ABC crew, because I love him. And hi, Mom, I'm fine. And hi to my Miss D and Lisa, my daughter, because I love him.
Okay, good luck to you, and congratulations on the victory.
Thank you.
Take care, Rich.
And I love you, Earnie.
All right, why don't you stay here and say hello to Earnie, and we'll be back to talk with Earnie Shavers and Larry Holmes in just a minute. We're coming to you live from ringside in Las Vegas, Nevada. We're back live ringside, Las Vegas, Nevada. Water being poured all over Larry Holmes and all over me and all over Rich Giacchetti. And here is the gallant Earnie Shavers. Question number one. Did you think you knocked him down when referee Pearl ruled it a slip in the ninth round, the second apparent knockdown?
Yeah, Howard, I thought I knocked him down. But I guess it was a slip. The referee said it was a slip, but I thought I was knocked down myself.
Now, were you upset by Larry staying in his dressing room late at the start of the fight?
Well, that didn't bother me too much. No, I was okay. I guess he's the champ. He wanted to try to let me get cold or burn myself out moving. But, that's part of the trick of the trade.
Will you agree that there's no dog in either of you? You put up a great scrap.
Well, yeah, I think Larry put a great fight up. I got thumbed in the third round. I couldn't see him that well. Not taking nothing away from Larry. He was a good fighter, but I did get thumbed twice in the third. And I was blurry. I couldn't really see Larry that clear.
I knew you couldn't.
But, yeah.
I'll tell you this. You won the hearts of a lot of people in this arena, and I'm sure millions around the country. Because you're a gallant man.
Well, Howard, Larry haven't seen the last of me. I'll be back. Give me 6 months. I'll be back.
Somehow, I almost believe it. You've done it so many times before. But that's your decision, and Frank Luca. And you can feel proud, too, Frank. You did a fine job.
He fought a great fight. He's the first time anybody put Holmes on his back. And I told him he would deck him, and he did. And I feel that he had him down twice. But Larry won the fight, and Earnie will be back.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and thank you, Earnie. And even in defeat, our congratulations to you. As the two men shake hands. It's been an extraordinary evening. We said we thought with this card we would have dynamite action. We did. Quickly, let's review the whole evening. Wilfredo Gomez in a very tough fight, unexpectedly tough, TKO'd Carlos Mendoza in the 10th round. Sugar Ray Leonard with an absolutely awesome performance. Brilliant. Put away Andy Hawk Price in 252 of the first round. A puffy Roberto Sluggish Durant won a unanimous decision over Zeffy Gonzalez. And then this WBC heavyweight championship belt with Larry Holmes, the TKO winner in the 11th round. We think that it was a fine night of boxing. We think boxing fans deserve it. They've been waiting too long for this kind of action. But we got it tonight. From Las Vegas, Nevada, for Chris Schenkel and myself, so long from ringside. Once again, Larry Holmes has successfully defended his WBC World Heavyweight title with an 11th round TKO of Earnie Shavers.
Be sure to join us tomorrow for NCAA college football doubleheader at 12:30 Eastern Time. Top regional games highlighted by Penn State at Nebraska, followed at 4 Eastern Time by Ohio State against UCLA. Check your local listings for the game in your area. The executive producer of ABC Sports is Rue Knowledge. Coverage of tonight's fight produced by Chet Forty, directed by Joe Assetti. Technical director Bill Morris, associate producer Alex Wallow, associate director John DeLeese. The WBC World Heavyweight Championship fight was brought to you by Michelob Light. It's simply a matter of good taste. And by the American Eagle, a new family compact with automatic four-wheel drive. Travel arrangements made through, promotional fee paid by United Airlines. United is building the largest airline in the world around you. This has been a presentation of the leader, ABC Sports, bringing you exclusive coverage when the world comes to America for the 1980 Winter Olympics. So long.